this.
Oh, wow.
Okay, before we pull this out, I want to ask you a question. Did you grow up listening to anyone on the radio that influenced you, like, musically, like I did?
I grew up listening to everybody on the radio. I come from a music house.
Yeah.
Like, my dad was a jazz trumpet player.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah, so I have deep musical roots in jazz. So Reggie Workman, Don Cherry, who is actually Cherry and Eagle Eye Cherry's dad.
Yeah.
Yes. Was a Reggie Workman bass player, used to be at my house regularly. So Earth, Wind & Fire and Ohio Players and Chaka Khan and Stevie Wonder and all of that was all going through our house. And our house was crazy because my dad was from Brooklyn and we moved to Teaneck, and he was kind of outside of the box. So, you know, we lived in a kind of like middle class neighborhood. Uh-huh. And we were like the bums on the block. And what he'd do is, you know, in the summertime, man, he'd open up the door to the house and just blast the music, man. So, like, music.
This is your household?
Yes, man. This was my household, yeah.
Well, geez, Master G, it's no wonder you are who you are.
I came up through music, man, really.
Yeah, that seriously. Sounds pretty influential.
My dad was actually my first drum teacher, too. He gave me
really?
A metronome, yeah.
Did you ever play with your dad, like you on drums and your dad on trumpet?
He never allowed me that privilege. I always had to practice in front of him.
Gotcha.
Yeah, but it was cool. He was good.
He was clearly your master.
He was my master. He was.
Yeah. So, speaking of masters and masters of radio, really, I grew up on Stretchin' Bobbito.
Okay.
Okay, and these are the brand new Puma Edition suede Bobbitos.
I don't have these.
You take one, I take one.
I got some.
Here we go. Get some zoo. Oh my God.
Look at that right there.
Oh, I love smelling shoes. Is that weird? Look at those.
You see that? That is a nice shoe right there.
Look at that. See the Bobbito? Yeah, look at the Bobbito.
Whoa.
I know. Can you get inside the sneaker? Can you see that?
Oh, right, yeah.
What does it say? Where'd you get those? Where'd you get those? Look at the sole. I'm in love with these. Oh my God, I love these so much. Okay, let's put these in the front here. Wow. Oh my God.
Those are hot.
All right, so we're going to have to do some research and find out if Bobbito is the first ever radio jock to have his own sneakers.
That might be the case.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, that might be the case. What we have?
Look at this. What do we have here?
Uh-oh.
Oh, wait. Where is this? Hold on. I'm going down.
Thank you.
I'm back.
Okay.
All right.
Here we go.
Here, where is this coming in from? We like to tell the people. Okay. This is international.
Is it?
This is international. This is coming in from Australia, Master G.
Oh, okay.
Coming in from Australia. Good day, mate. Tell me what you got for the Hip Hop Museum. That was a weird accent. That didn't work. I turned like hillbilly. I was like Australian into hillbilly. While he's doing that, let me tell you. Did you know that the Netflix show Rapture is coming out with its soundtrack? That's right. The Rapture is coming out with its soundtrack. And the soundtrack features Nas, Dave East, Logic, G-Eazy, Rhapsody, 2 Chainz, T.I., Just Blaze, and A Boogie with the Hoodie. Are you familiar with this show on Netflix, Bdubb? Because that sounds really good. And that's Friday, May 18th, today, the soundtrack to the show Rapture on Netflix is coming out today. And I feel immediately bad that we have asked you to do like administrative work on our show.
I have no domestic at all. Let me be real with you. None.
Wait. Oh God. Cause this might be your own record.
Trust me, you should be at my house and listen to my wife get in my case about the fact that I have no domestic skills.
So what are you
all
saying? That you don't do the laundry at home?
I'm not a laundry guy. No.
God.
I'm sorry. I don't do laundry.
What did they do to this package?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, it's coming from Australia, so it's probably delivered in a kangaroo.
Something.
All right. My goodness.
But I'm a great provider. I don't do laundry, but I'm a great provider. So, yes.
What was the name of your guys' second album?
Eighth Wonder. Eighth Wonder album. We did the Sugar Hill Gang album was the first, and then the second album was the Eighth Wonder album. That's the one where I got the Egyptian outfit on. We did that. That was actually on my 19th birthday. That picture was taken on my 19th birthday.
Oh, my God. That was the most anticlimactic. All right. I'm telling you. D&D Allstars. We'll just D&D hold it up. I mean, okay. It's like, oh, right. It's, you know, they put the record on the outside. This is whatever. Okay, zoom in on the label. This is D&D Allstars, one of the greatest studios in New York City.
Yeah.
Some of the greatest work with some of the greatest rappers. This may have been the most anticlimactic unboxing we've ever done. Goodbye. Thank you, D&D.
Where we have here?
Okay, we always say where it's coming from. Las Vegas.
Las Vegas. Okay, let's see.
Las Vegas. Here we go. Hopefully this one.
Hopefully I can get this one.
Yeah, okay. While you're doing that, I want to tell you that Anderson .Paak, we love Anderson .Paak. And let me tell you, it's been roughly a year and a half since he dropped that album. And he's finally jumping back into the mix with his new track entitled Bubblin', the follow-up to Till It's Over. And Yes, Lord, that's the name of the album, Yes, Lord. He sat down with, hold on a second. Yes, so he's collaborating with Dr. Dre. Okay, long story short. The new single, Bubblin', is produced by Dr. Dre, Anderson .Paak. Go get it. It's got a video, too. Now, this is part of a series that we're into called the Stop the Violence series, Self-Destruction. And this is the single, the Stop the Violence single.
Nice.
And we've been experiencing, unfortunately, difficulty, plight of some violence here in the city.
Yeah, I know.
Gun violence. And so we're working here with Eddie Kane, one of our top broadcasters, to work with the kids and might even be doing a gun buyback.
Oh, that would be great. So, that's a great idea.
So we're really trying to...
I would love to do anything I could to help.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Well, we'll keep you in mind for that because we're thinking that if we offer a kid some studio time, you know, for his gun, that he'd be willing to give it up to kind of maybe start a career.
Yep.
Okay.
Who knows? You might end up traveling the world.
You never know.
You
might end up at a pizzeria with the right woman.
Exactly.
And in the studio with two other guys. And create a genre of music.
Change the world.
Jeez Louise. I'm sitting next to a man who created a genre of music.
We didn't create it. We brought it to the world.
Well,
I am you
are the messenger.
We're messengers. I won't say we're creators. We're messengers.
Well, somebody had to bring that art to the people. And you guys were the first to do it commercially. And I am a huge Masta Ace fan. Masta Ace just recently did a Tiny Desk concert at National Public Radio, where I used to be a producer. And this is Masta Ace's single, Jeep Ass N-Word, that I can't say that. And
I was waiting.
Yeah, and on the other side is Saturday Night Live.
What we got going on here.
But let me tell you, the reason why we got this, have you ever seen... Translucent vinyl. That's right, fellas.
Whoa.
That's right. So, Masta Ace.
Oh.
This is really one of my favorite records I had as a DJ. And we also have our intern just hung up Masta Ace's INC record, which is signed upstairs where the rest of the collection is. And we'll take you around, Master G, to show you all the rest of the collection. Well, let's say who is this? Who is where is it coming in from? Cary, North Carolina. Okay, coming in from Cary, North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Okay, and while you're doing that, I'm going to tell you about MC Paul Barman has always existed on the proverbial margins of rap. His intricate lyricism and quirky style are just as endearing to some as they are off-putting to others, making him a cult figure in hip-hop. So if you're a fan of MC Paul Barman... about the most Jewish MC in the history of MCs, Fans of Barman can count themselves among some of hip-hop's most respected artists. What do we have here? I don't know why they always box it with these random records. Look at this.
Look at this.
Picture disc. Brain, the single.
The Jungle Brothers. I do a lot of stuff with them overseas.
Do you?
Oh, yeah, in Hungary. I've been in a lot of different countries with Jungle Brothers. They're always overseas. I think actually one of them is living in Germany now.
Well, interestingly enough, DJ Red Alert is the reason why I became a DJ.
Red Alert's a great guy.
You know, and Red Alert introduced me to the Jungle Brothers. Great yes!
Guy. Red Alert's a great guy.
That was my horrible impression.
Did you say they were actually in Germany?
Yeah.
What's going on with actually rappers in Germany now?
Germany loves hip-hop.
Yeah.
Yep.
Germany loves
hip-hop.
Germany loved... The first place I ever went to when I left America as a rapper was Bremen, Germany. That was the first place. And
Japan loves hip hop too.
I just came back from Japan the beginning of this year.
We did a
place called Billboard Live in Osaka and Tokyo. We were there actually New Year's. That's how we brought the New Year's in this year.
Wow. In Osaka. Just to finish off my thought earlier, if you want to pick up MC Paul Barman's new album, it features Prince Paul, Questlove, and MF Doom. Those are three of my favorite hip hop humans ever. In other news, Wale, was kind of on a little hiatus there in between labels, but he has now been picked up by Warner Brothers. So shout out to him. No, we can't do two of those. Can only have so many of something. Wow, there's a lot of administrative work happening here.
It's okay.
I'm so sorry. Where's this one coming in from?
Yeah, right. I forgot.
So we have, and this is Joseph. From Waterbury, Connecticut.
Waterbury, Connecticut. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I think this is the special one.
We were in New Haven earlier, a few months ago.
Okay, so I think this is the special one. I could be wrong.
I think we have been somewhere everywhere.
Yeah, you really have, huh?
We were here. We were there. We were here. And I'm like, oh, wow, you know what?
Well, your record went gold and then platinum.
Double platinum.
Yeah. And on Monday, J. Cole's KOD album was just certified gold,
nice.
Which is 500,000 units.
Yes.
All right.
For me to brew through this.
Here we go.
All that scissor stuff is definitely not my deal.
This guy's a brute force type of guy.
I have issues. I got some issues.
All right. Okay. Hold it down.
Hold it down.
All right. Of course, we have to unbox something that's obviously special to the show. Let's get this out of here. Let's hold it up. What do we got there? An original pressing, Sugar Hill Records. Wow. Who's that handsome guy?
Little fella in the middle. Let's see. Bam. There you go.
There he is. Let's look at him.
There you go.
You haven't aged a day.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Can we see the middle? Oh, my God.
Look
at that. That's a handsome man.
Look at this guy.
Look at that jacket. What is that, satin?
Yeah, it was satin, actually. It was custom made.
Is that a hoodie?
Yes, it was a
Is that a satin hoodie?
It was a custom made.
Was your zipper not working?
Oh, it was definitely working.
Show us the back. Show us the back.
Of course, the back.
Yeah, there it is.
Wow.
Booyah.
Wow, look at that guy. You have really maybe one of the best hairlines I've ever seen in my life.
And I still have it.
I know.
And that's my thing. And I'm up there. Trust me.
Listen, without further ado, we would like... This is the one that's really going into the collection. Yeah. This is the real deal. Yeah. You could do this on the front.
I just want to show you something real quick.
Oh, okay, yeah.
This will show you right here. It says...
This is Guy O'Brien, 17 years old. He was born in Englewood, New Jersey, which is not true, where he is now a senior at Dwight Morrow High School. His hobbies are football, basketball, gymnastics, and flying. Guy has a student pilot license. That's true.
I was actually flying planes when I was going on.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to think of things to say. I'm completely speechless.
That's true.
What type of high school student flies? Can we just get a quick little quick little close-up of this.
Yeah.
Of this kind of these liner notes here.
Yeah, that was the real deal, boy. Right that was the real deal. See down there on the bottom?
Guy O'Brien.
That's me.
Master G.
I was born in Manhattan, but they, you know, don't believe everything you read. But Dwight Morrow was the high school that I got discovered. I was into Dwight Morrow, and I thought I could play football. I thought I could play basketball. I was good at gymnastics, but I really loved flying. My dad was a pilot, and that's
unbelievable. That's how I got into flying. Unbelievable. Well, thank you so much. As you're signing that, I'm going to tell them a last little piece of hip-hop news here, and that's the Prince Estate has greenlit a tribute tour in honor of the late music icon titled For You, a symphonic celebration of Prince. Okay? Wow. Curated by the Roots drummer Questlove, the set will be performed by the Wolf Trap Orchestra. That's Wolf Trap. Here.
Yeah.
Yeah. With additional contributions from a live band and several vocalists. They will reimagine a mixture of Prince's classic songs and deeper cuts pulled from his expansive catalog.
Yeah. That's going to be very nice. Very nice.
I'm sorry. I'm trying not to be in shock right now.
It's okay.
I'm allowed to be human. Oh, my God. This is crazy. I can't believe this is happening. Okay. I want to ask you just the last couple questions here.
Okay, cool.
Pertaining to your career. So,
yes.
Musically, you guys got back together, though.
Yes.
You know, despite all the difficulties, you guys got back together and did, I guess, a kid's record, right?
Yeah, that was in the 90s.
99?
Yeah, that was 99. And 99?
Was that the first time getting back together after everything?
That was the first. Well, we actually weren't even officially back together. We just did a project together because I was still outside of the group situation, but we had an opportunity to do the project, so we did that project. So we kind of did one of those come and do the project, and then I was back again running my companies.
So
we officially, Mike and myself have officially rebooted the Sugar Hill Gang in April of 2005. That is the official date that Sugar Hill Gang, our version of Sugar Hill Gang, our exclusive version. We manage it, we run it, we make all the
decisions.
Is there
a third member?
There is a third member. There's actually, his name is Hen Dog. And he was performing with the other fact. The other situation when Mike was still with the record company, and when Mike left the record label situation, he brought Hen Dog with him, and then also introduced me to a guy named T Dynasty, who is our DJ, and he's co-written some of the stuff that we've done internationally, because you know we just had a hit a couple of years ago in France with a cat named Bob Sinclair. We did a big record with him.
Wow.
And so his name is T Dynasty. So the third member is Hen Dog. T Dynasty's our DJ, and that version of Sugar Hill Gang has been touring the world and doing the things that we've done Arsenio, we did Jimmy, we did Conan.
Right.
Yeah, we've done all that stuff.
And so, you know, just like, you know, in closing, because there's no closing with you. Now that you're in this area,
I'm here, yes.
And that I'm aware of that.
I'm in the mix.
I'm gonna try not to stalk you, but
I'm in the mix.
But I want to know, what do you see for yourself music? I mean, you've accomplished so much musically already. You've accomplished so much in the business world. But, you know, I don't know if you're like myself that, you know, if you go a certain amount
done.
Of time, you
I'm
know.
I'm not done.
What do you envision? What do you envision?
Well, you know, my envision musically is that I want to have the opportunity to collaborate with some individuals that I have admired and that I feel are, you know, really profound individuals, just individuals, period. Just, you know, people like Sting, the group, Dave Grohl, the Foo Fighters.
Well, you want to expand.
Yes, you know, who is from the area. Dave Grohl is from D.C., isn't he?
Yes.
Yeah.
He sure is. Arlington, Virginia.
That's right. Not too far from me.
Yeah.
But.
So is Bad Brains.
Yes. Yes. See, yeah. Yeah. So there's so many things that I want to do on a rock level. I want to write some ballads. I'm a drummer, so I would like to do some stuff where I'm actually playing and not necessarily vocals.
Right.
I want to be the music
side
of it.
You just want to, get your expand creatively.
And then my secret ambition, which everybody still has yet to know, is that initially I wanted to be a disc jockey on the radio. Because if you come from New York, you remember a guy named Frankie Crocker. I saw WBLS
of
up there.
Of course.
Frankie Crocker was a personal family friend of ours. My father also was a flight instructor. So he taught Frankie how to fly.
Yeah.
So Frankie Crocker.
Mr. Magic learned from Frankie.
Yeah. Mr. Magic learned from Frankie.
Right.
Yes. And Magic was a good friend of mine as well.
Right.
So Frankie Crocker used to come to my house. So I was a big fan of his. And I wanted to be the next Frankie Crocker. I just got sidetracked when I met Sylvia. And, you know,
what
so
a,
my goal
just
was,
a little sidetracked.
Yeah, and I tell people that it was a great sidetrack, but a sidetrack nonetheless.
Right.
Because I had already applied for an FCC license. My father was helping me do that.
Oh, wow.
I had applied for an FCC license. And I was always told I had a good voice, and, you know, that I spoke.
And you have an incredible voice. And interestingly enough, Kaz has kind of reinvented himself as a DJ.
Exactly. So my ambition, my real ambition musically, is to have a radio show. That's my real goal.
Well, newsflash.
Hey.
We might have a situation for you. And not only that, but we're also DC's largest and oldest recording studio.
Oh, well, and see, there it is.
There's
there
a lot. So I feel like this is the beginning of something.
Yeah, I think so, too.
Of something big.
I think so, too.
So, listen, you know, we're always here with my DJ. Oh, did you? Thank you. But my DJ, the one, the only.
B-Dub, the boy wonder.
Can we get a quick camera on B-Dub? I feel like our new sidebar has lost my DJ. Well, B-Dub, where can people catch you if they want you to DJ, you know, their bar mitzvah, or their bris, or their sweet 16, their quinceañera?
Everything.
Hey. Bar mitzvahs are good money.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Trust me.
You don't need to tell me or Jacob. Me.
Backyard parties, all that.
I know.
Sorry. Go ahead, B-Dub. Where can we find you?
That was my fault. I had a moment.
Everything's at djbdub.com. Everything's at djbdub.com. Appreciate you.
djbdub.com. Okay, because, you know, everybody needs a DJ from now and then, and he will pop up, and he's not only great on the turntables, he's actually a radio vet.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's actually the weirdest thing that I'm talking and he's DJing, because I'm a DJ and he's a radio host.
See, yeah, it's all right. I'm in the galaxy.
You're in the hip hop matrix right now.
Yeah.
I think he's realizing that. Yeah, I think all the cannabis is kind of floating over to him.
And this is another thing right here.
It's new for you too, huh?
Yeah, a little bit new for me.
Yeah.
Not necessarily my forte there. I don't even drink wine. You know?
Oh, wow.
So, yeah.
No, I don't drink either.
Yeah,
I
but I'm cool with it. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah. Well, speaking of things that
comes
are...
from the earth.
Speaking of drinking things, I want to thank Highball, our sponsor.
Yes.
When your balls are feeling low, Highball, they'll pick you right up and give you all the energy you need.
Yeah.
Highball.
Yeah.
Oh, let me take a sip, because you know what? Thank you, guys. But Highball, you give me the pep I need every single week.
There it is.
You want to taste some of my
balls?
I'll
let you.
No, okay, cool.
I'll let you work that out.
Yeah, that's good. That's all good.
I just go ahead and...
Next up. Hey, don't touch my balls.
No.
Oh, hell, okay.
I touched the side of your balls.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, that's all right. I accept that. Wow,
no homo.
Master G touched my highball.
Yeah, no homo. No homo.
Oh, my God. Full homo.
If you say no homo, then it's okay.
Then it's okay.
Yeah. No homo.
I said full homo. That.
Definitely pause. You got to say pause. Definitely. Yes.
What has happened? I can't believe the show has devolved.
Safe word.
Pineapple.
Macaroni and cheese. Chicken tastes like wood.
Pineapple. Pineapple. All right.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
I think we're safe.
Okay, we're cool.
Oh, my God. Master G. Thank you so much.
Thank you, man.
I can't believe that this moment has happened.
No.
I can't believe this moment has happened.
I can't believe I'm still here for this moment. I'm thankful for that.
Anyways, every single Friday, I am Jeremy Beaver, CEO and founder of Listen Vision, and you are tuned in to District Spotlight. And let me tell you, we're going to end up with an incredible promo that our digital content manager, Jacob Moss, just cut together of a lot of the memorabilia we have here. We are now inducting this into the collection. Can we get a close up? It's like a before and after, right? Before, what's the years between that?
This is
hold it below your chin. There you go.
Okay.
There you go. What's the years?
That's 79, and this is 2015.
Oh, thanks.
I mean 2018.
Thanks. I know what year this is.
Oh, my fault. That's 79.
Okay, so 80, 20, 40.
39 years.
Yeah. Incredible.
39 years.
Unbelievable.
I'm 56 this year.
Yeah.
This happened.
My age. That's
this funny. Really happened. I want to thank you guys. I want to thank our audience. I want to thank our viewers.
I guess I don't look too bad.
And if you want to catch this episode again, or if you missed any part of it, the entire episode will be on YouTube.
Oh, cool.
Right after.
Good.
So and next Friday at 5, please tune in. Until then, I'm Jeremy Beaver, and peace out.
Peace and hair grease.